Up Winthrop High School.
I'm Nicoletta, nice to see ya.
And I'm Carly, and I'm back again.
Today is November 8th, and we're following a day 5 schedule.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence.
The staff of Wake Up Winthrop High School and the entire Winthrop High School community would like to thank Ms. Stein for her years of dedicated service to the students of Winthrop High School.
You have been an excellent part of our school and have helped countless students throughout their high school careers. Although we will miss you here at Winthrop, we wish you the best of luck in your future. Please know you'll always be part of the Winthrop High School community.
For the month of November, the Period 6 Life Skills Math class would like to encourage in joining alongside them and bringing in old blankets to help North Shore Animal Shelter. You can bring in the items to a drop box outside of room 109.
John Cohen is an 11-year-old in the middle school battling cancer. A few teachers have collection cans which donations can be placed into. No donation is too small.
Hey Outdoors Clubbers, permission slips are posted for our trip. Print from the Google Classroom homepage.
Please report to guidance Gavin Abbott, Regan Allen, Jordan Bernard, Cameron Carrillo, Simone Camilo, Justice Falcone, Caitlin Javoli, Katie Kraja, Charles Lane, Tyler Souza, Kevin Noseworthy, Xavier Vega Perez, Andrea Zapata, Stephen Reardon, Giovanna Matera, Gianna Tervani, Samuel Flores, Marco Tollier, and Luis Rosado.
The annual blood drive is upon us. Make sure you see a senior class officer during lunch to sign up and get more info.
Everyone grab your homecoming tickets. It's going to be a real ball. Homecoming will be on November 23rd at Pleasant Park Yacht Club, 7 to 10.
There will be pizza, a DJ, a photo booth, and the theme will be Viking Pride.
Here's what our field reporter has to say about what's to come at homecoming. Enjoy.
November is here. This means homecoming is just around the corner. Homecoming is a dance where everybody gets together to celebrate pep rally and the big Thanksgiving football game. And for freshmen, it's their first high school dance.
Every year, the sophomores are in charge of creating the theme and organizing homecoming. This year, the sophomores are organizing a Viking-themed dance that will take place on Saturday, November 23rd at the Pleasant Park Yacht Club. The dance will run from 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. and will include food, drinks, and even a photo booth. We caught up with some of the sophomores and asked them what can be expected at this year's dance, along with a few students who showed us some of their dance moves.
People should expect a really fun time at homecoming because everyone, all the sophomore social committee people and STUCO members are working really hard to make it a really fun time and acceptable for everyone. All grades should come out because it's not just sophomore, freshman, because people think it is, but everyone should really come out. It's a great time.
I expect a lot. So like probably all the seniors would probably tease all the freshmen and it'll be a lot of fun. It'll be fun.
I think homecoming is about to be different this year because I think it's going to be way more organized because people put in a lot of time towards it, more time than last year, so we're excited to see that.
I'm most excited for like all the food, all the dancing, and I think it's honestly going to be a really good homecoming compared to like all the previous ones because I feel like a lot more people are going
to
show up.
I'm most excited this year to see who's going to take my crown from last year because last year there was a little mishap and I ended up winning Homecoming King, but we don't talk about that.
What I'm most excited about for homecoming is just to see friends and hang out and most of all, just have some fun.
Here we have some students who were eager to show us their dance moves.
Thanks, guys. Those are some pretty cool moves. Hope this got everyone excited for the homecoming dance. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Catherine. Sounds like a great time. I hope you guys have fun.
Can't wait to see your pics on Insta.
With fall sports ending very soon and playoffs coming to a quick end, the football team and girls soccer team pushed through and played this week in some fierce games.
Here's what our field reporter, Sunita, has to say.
With fall sports quickly coming to a close, the boys football team and the girls soccer team continue to compete in some exciting matchups this week. The girls soccer team ended their awesome season with an 11-9 record, while the boys football team continues to push through their heavy schedules. The boys football team had a tough loss against the 3-5 Hamilton Wenham Generals. The team started off with a drive down the field when they lost possession of the ball, and Hamilton Wenham quickly went down and scored. At the start of the second half, the Vikings recovered a chipped kick that was quickly turned into a touchdown by Bobby Hubert. Alongside him, Victor Marquez spiked one off for the Vikings. The boys will play Under the Lights at home on Friday at 7 o'clock. Come pop out and support our team. I caught up with a few of the players to hear about how they can try to respond from the loss and take on the Arlington Catholic Cougars.
So my name is Mikey Shav, sophomore quarterback for Winthrop Vikings. Being a sophomore on varsity has been hard. Had to overcome a lot of obstacles, but like, just got to win on Thanksgiving, and that's all I really care about.
I think the game plan for the defense this week is to stay disciplined and to really stay on their blocks and make plays happen, because I feel like we've been struggling to really push through and finally make like a score.
The offense kind of struggled to score because we were missing blocks and we were struggling on third and fourth down. But we're going to try to fix that up for this week.
The thing that I'm going to miss the most from the season is probably the connection and the bond that I have with all the players. I really got super close to all the teammates and everyone there. Although it was my first year, I really feel like this was a family.
The girls' varsity soccer team had a huge win against Mystic Valley this past Sunday, winning 2-1 with the first goal coming from forward Mia Martucci. The Mystic Valley Eagles responded with a goal. Both defenses and goaltenders played an excellent second half, with Manuela Mejia getting the second half shutout. Junior Mara Dor was able to finish off the game with a double overtime goal. The girls then traveled to Amesbury Wednesday to take on the Amesbury Indians. Amesbury went out to an early lead, scoring the first two goals. The Indians also scored the first goal of the second half. Junior Mara Dor tried to get the Vikes back into the game with a goal, but Amesbury responded quickly with their own goal late in the second. Mara scored what would be the last goal of the 2019 season, with the games ending 4-2 in Amesbury's favor. The girls had an amazing season. I caught up with a few of the team members to hear about their amazing season.
After taking the loss, it was really sad, but overall it was a really good season. It was probably our best one yet, and that game was probably our best. I mean, going against the number one seed and keeping up with them and at least scoring two goals on them and almost three, it was really good, and I'm really proud of us.
My favorite memory was going into double overtime in the Mystic Valley game and then watching Mo take a shot from like 30 yards out and watching it like soar right over the goalie.
No matter how hard it got, we pushed through. Even though our division changed, we played all hard teams no matter what. Like, we, all the losses we got, we pushed through and play our hardest, and that's all that matters.
Even though it's always tough taking a loss, we went into the Amesbury game like kind of, well, we lost last time and it was like a tough game. So we weren't that hopeful, but we ended up not giving up, and it was like a really good game. We kept up with them the whole time, which I can't say about last game.
Congratulations to the girls soccer team on yet another amazing season, and good luck to the seniors in their future, and we can't wait to see what the undergraduates achieve next year. Now let's make sure to be here at home on Friday under the lights to support our boys at home. Now back to you guys in the studio.
Good luck to all our seniors and congrats on a good season. We'll miss seeing you guys on the field on Friday nights.
Can't wait to see where sports will take you guys in college. Underclassmen, it's time to step up and take control now.
Get it together, juniors. It's your time to shine.
Hey, Carly, do you smell that?
Smell what? Oh, you mean the glitter, the face paint, the sweat, the pride, the tears, the seniors?
Pep rally? Get ready, everyone, and bring out your Viking pride. Pep rally at WHS is a big deal.
Here's Dylan Riley with the pep rally hype video.
Thanks, guys. With Thanksgiving a few weeks away, Winthrop High School starts to see new events that start to pop up, one of the most anticipating being pep rally.
Pep rally is held the day before Thanksgiving, where the whole school comes together and cheers on the football team for their big game the next day on Thanksgiving. Pep rally is also an event that sees the seniors, juniors, sophomores, and freshmen battle it out in games. Classes accumulate points when they win events, which leads to a winner at the end. I caught up with some different students and teachers to see who they think will get pep rally glory.
Hey, it's been 4 long years. 4 long years. In this class of 2020, we never won pep rally. But this year is our year. Our year to take home that W. In pep rally and on the football field. Let's go Vikes.
I don't know like how much luck we have against the seniors, but I know we're gonna beat the freshmen.
Man, it's that, that best time of year again. It's that time where we all get to sit in that beautiful gymnasium and we get to cheer on our fellow students. I love it. I love it, and I'm feeling really good about it this year, let me tell you, because Mr. Palin is the senior class advisor, in case you haven't heard. And I know that in the past, the seniors haven't brought it as much as they should have brought it, to be quite honest with you. But this year, let me tell you, that our seniors are going to be jumping up and down, screaming real loud.
I don't even know what pep rally is, but I'm just confident in the freshmen because the seniors aren't even that tough, and they can't compete with us, so freshmen strong.
This is my first year as an upperclassman at pep rally, and I think we have a really good chance of winning. I'm really excited. Let's do it, junior class. Woo!
So I have a lot of sophomore and junior students, but I don't know if they really have much on the seniors.
Yeah, I don't really know what the pep rally hype is all about, but one thing I do know is that the freshmen got to take home the dub, because the seniors got nothing on us, the juniors got nothing on us, the sophomores got nothing on us. Freshmen taking dubs all the time.
Get out of here.
So get ready for those seniors at pep rally this year. You freshmen, you sophomores, you juniors, you got no chance, because Palin and the class of 2020 are coming for you.
Are you ready for pep rally? Are you ready? We only got a few weeks left. Freshmen, sophomores, juniors, seniors. Who's it gonna be? Who's gonna take home the pep rally crown this year? My money's on the seniors, but who's gonna take it? We only got a couple weeks left.
But the cream will rise to the top, oh yeah.
There looks to be some heated competition amongst the grades at the moment. I hope this carries into pep rally. I'm Dylan Riley, now back to you guys in the studio.
Wow, I bleed blue and golds.
I can't wait to lose my voice from yelling at the freshmen to go home.
Okay, thanks for tuning in. We hope you enjoyed our take on this week's news. Please keep us in mind if your club, sport, or class is doing something newsworthy.
Roll Vikes.
I'm sorry.